Hey guys, and welcome back for another video. In this video, we're going to be picking right up where we left off with the last video, where we got the Elegy armor set, and at the end of that video, I mentioned that there's actually a second tier to the Elegy armor set, called the Requiem armor set, and that is what we're going for today. This probably goes without saying, but you do need to complete the Elegy armor set collection before this becomes unlocked, and in addition to that requirement, there are several items that you may want to track down ahead of time. Before we head any further with this guide, I want to make sure that you guys know what items you'll need and how to get them if you don't have them already. First up, we have Mistonium, and you're going to need 440 pieces. Mistonium can be found throughout the entirety of Jahai Bluffs, both as a mineable node and an interactable object. Upon completing each one of the three hearts in the Jahai Bluffs map, you'll be able to speak with the heart vendor and pick up 5 additional Mistonium for some karma, and this will be 5 Mistonium per heart per character. Additionally, if you 100% map complete the Jahai Bluffs, you'll be awarded with 25 per character. And even by simply completing some of the events in the Jahai Bluffs, you'll gain a few more. In addition to Mistonium, you're also going to need 100 globs of ectoplasm. These can be purchased off the trading post, or if you'd prefer, you can salvage these from level 68 rare gear or better. You'll also need 3,337 volatile magic. You can get this a wide variety of ways, considering it's more or less just a generic reward for completing content involving the Living World Season 4. Doing basically anything in those maps will award you some volatile magic, but I would recommend focusing on events as they're the most repeatable content. Next up, you'll need 30 piles of crystalline dust. These can be purchased off the trade post and are a pretty regular drop from level 80 loot bags. After that, you're going to need about 45 watchwork sprockets, and this is actually an older resource from some of the earlier content in Guild Wars. There are a whole wide variety of ways to get this item, but I would highly recommend just purchasing them off the trading post because they're fairly inexpensive. Moving on, we're going to need about 25 sigils of nullification. And unfortunately, I'm going to recommend that you purchase these off the trading post despite their price. This because the Sigil of Nullification cannot be crafted, it can only be salvaged from items that drop with a Sigil of Nullification inside of them. If for some reason you happen to have a lot of Tomes of Knowledge, you can choose this as a level 64 reward option if you just happen to have a ton of character slots and free level ups. But unfortunately, outside of that, your best bet is just to fork over the gold, that is if you really want this skin. With that in mind, we do still have 3 more items we'll need. First of those is going to be Amalgamated Gems, and you're going to need about 20 of those. These can be purchased off the trading post or crafted a wide variety of ways. So many ways, in fact, that I'm actually just going to leave a link in the description, so if anybody out there would prefer to maybe craft these over purchasing them, you'll at least have the information at your disposal. After that, you're going to need 2 of the plus 10 swim speed infusions. Like a fair amount of the items on this list, you can purchase these on the trading post, but these can also be earned pretty easily on your own. A while back now, there was a new daily added to the game. All you'll need to do is slay any 10 crate out in the open world, and when you do, you'll be rewarded with a key. This key opens several sunken chests around Coreteria, and one of the potential drops out of that chest are these plus 10 swim speed infusions. And the last item you'll need in order to complete this collection is a thermal emplacement. For this, you'll just have to head over to Mount Maelstrom in Coreteria. Here, in the very center of the volcano itself, you should see an outstretched ledge that actually has an interactable object, and all you'll have to do is interact with that to get this item. And now, with all of that out of the way, we can actually start the collection. Back in the Jahai Bluffs at the Yetendi Village waypoint, you should head to the area just south of that waypoint. Here, you're looking for an event called Defend Zaya as she searches for Vemyan. Now, while the event starts just below that waypoint, that doesn't mean that it's going to stay there, and it's because of this I recommend looking at both Looking for Group as well as your map chat to make sure the event hasn't already started. The event itself isn't very difficult as long as you have a few people with you, and as with most other defense events, you're just going to be taking taking out waves of enemies that are attacking Zaya until she makes it all the way to Vemyon. Once you make it to Vemyon, you'll have to fight him as sort of a mini-boss, and again, as long as you have enough people in your party, this shouldn't be too hard to deal with. Once you've completed this event, you'll talk to Zaya one more time, and she'll actually give you a bit of dialogue before heading to Sun's Refuge. And so, as you might have guessed at this point, we need to head to Sun's Refuge to talk to Zaya. Speaking with Zaya in Sun's Refuge is going to give you a couple of dialogue options, and it's a good idea to make sure you pick the second one. This because each one of the dialogue options is going to unlock part of a collection, but we really only need to focus on the second dialogue option for this guide. Be sure that you've unlocked the Convergence of Sorrow 2, and we can now make our way north of Sun's Refuge towards the Ancestor Tree. There is an event that's constantly taking place around the Ancestor Tree that will be in one of three phases. In one of the phases, you'll be collecting djinn vessels. In the next phase, you'll be taking on branded so that they don't increase a branded energy level. And in the third phase, there'll be absolutely nothing happening at all. Each one of these phases or temporal shifts lasts 10 minutes, and that's actually regardless of whether or not the event has been completed. So let's say you're doing the djinn event and you complete it in 4 minutes, you're still gonna have to wait the remaining 6 minutes. It's because of these several minute gaps that it can become kind of confusing as to which phase the event is actually on, and to make this as simple as possible, I recommend simply waiting until you see the djinn event spawn, because that's actually where we'll need to start. You can tell it's on this particular phase when you see some djinn vessels all around the ground, and you'll basically just need to pick up enough of these until the event is over. When the event has been successfully completed, you'll need to speak with Vemyon, the djinn, as well as Micah, the NPC, stood right behind him. Once you've spoken to both of those NPCs, quickly head to Sun's Refuge and speak with Amira from our first video, if you'll recall, and it's here that you'll get your next item. Then, quickly head back to the Ancestor Tree, hopefully before that 10-minute timer is over. As long as you're still on the same instance of the map, you should be able to speak with Micah one more time. From here, it's just a matter of waiting for the temporal shift. Whenever this happens and you're stood next to the Ancestor Tree, you will be teleported just outside of the tree's purple bubble, but you'll be able to walk right back in, so no worries. As I mentioned before, this event requires you to take out some branded as well as their crystals to avoid them building up too much branded energy. Be sure that you have a couple of people in your group, and this should be pretty easy. And once you're finally done, you'll be able to speak with another NPC. Head over to the Ancestor Tree itself, and just behind the tree, you should see an NPC named Nori. Speaking with Nori will get you your next item, and now it's just a matter of waiting for another temporal shift. If you've been paying attention, you know the next temporal shift is the one where nothing happens. The best indication of this is you won't see any real event markers, rather you'll just see a bunch of Iboga, and it's only during this phase that you'll be able to speak with an NPC known as Norima for your next item. Next up, we're looking for a mist entangled item. While you play on the Jahai Bluffs map, if you look around, you should see a portal symbol, and this is an indication of an event where you'll need to take on several waves of enemies. After taking on several enemies, you'll eventually spawn a Rift Stalker, and it's this enemy we need to defeat in order to get that mist entangled item. These events spawn all over the map, so just be sure to keep an eye out when you're on this step. Once you've successfully defeated any Riftstalker and got your Mist Entangled item, head back to Amira back at Sun's Refuge. Be sure that you speak with her one last time, and we can now move on to the final part of this collection. From here, we'll need to head over to the Dermin Priory Waypoint in Lornor's Pass. If you haven't explored much of Corteria, then you can head to the map just to the right of Lion's Arch. You won't be able to get there through Lion's Arch though, rather you'll have to head south through Bloodtide Coast, before heading east over to Lornor's Pass. From the waypoint, just head deeper into the Dermin Priory. When the map opens up into a circular room, be sure to stay on the left-hand side, and next to some grates on the floor, you can see this is an enterable instance. Now that you're inside of the Dermin Priory, you'll spawn on the steps, and you'll need to stay on the right-hand side, moving right around the circular room. The second doorway on the right-hand side will open up to a room full of NPCs, but in one of the far corners, you should see an NPC named Eli. Speaking with Eli will grant you access even deeper into the Derman Priory to a hidden area. Once again, after a short loading screen, you should find yourself in a giant library. Walk forward up the stairs next to the large statue, and once it opens up into the larger library room, you should see on the left-hand side an opening that goes back a little bit farther. Towards the back of the room, we'll find Eli once again. Speaking with Eli this time will unlock our first collection for the boots. Just to the right of Eli, you'll see a curiously empty bezel. Interacting with this will get you your first mist entangled item. Then you'll need to head back to Eli, who is now somewhat of a vendor, and for 50 lumps of Mistonium, 5 ectoplasm, 300 volatile magic, and 20 watchwork sprockets, you'll be able to pick up the demystifying device. Now that you have the required items, head back to the curiously empty bezel. After interacting with this, you can hit the red button next to Eli, and that'll unlock your boots. Now that you have the boots unlocked, you have a better understanding of how to handle each and every other piece of gear in this set. You'll have to go out to Jahai Bluffs and find your next Mist Entangled item. Once you receive that item, head back to Eli in this hidden area. Purchase any additional items required for each experiment. Place those items inside the curiously empty bezel. Once you have all of the items required for the experiment, hit the red button and you'll unlock your next piece of gear. It should be noted that before moving on to the next piece of gear, you'll actually have to select your boot skin. Each skin is actually part of the collection, so you'll need to double-click on the chest in your inventory and select a skin to move on. So, for our next Mist Entangled item, we need to head over to the Reclaimed Chantry Waypoint, or the northernmost waypoint in Jahai Bluffs. Right next to that waypoint, you should see a heart. After completing this heart, speak with the heart vendor in order to purchase your next Mist Entangled item. Once you've finished, head back to Eli in the hidden area inside the Derman Priory. Speaking with Eli again, you can see that he's still carrying the demystifying device, only it's sold for a slightly discounted price. And additionally, you'll need something called a spectrum filter that'll cost you 50 lumps of Mistonium, 5 ectoplasm, 300 volatile magic, and 10 crystalline dust. Once you're done, place those in the curiously empty bezel and hit the red button. Once again, be sure that you've actually selected a skin before moving on, and just like before, we'll be headed towards another heart that we'll need to complete, and then we'll be able to purchase our next Mist Entangled item from the heart vendor. This time, it'll be at Yetendi Village, and you'll just need to complete the nearby heart. Head back to Eli and we'll be purchasing all previous items. Here you can see that the spectrum filter has gone down in price from the last time that we purchased it. And like last time, there's a new item called the Anti-Siege Containment Field that we'll purchase for 50 lumps of Mistonium, 5 globs of ectoplasm, 300 volatile magic, and 10 superior sigils of nullification. Combine all items, hit the red button, be sure to select your skin, and now we can head over to the last heart, surprise, surprise. We're gonna go to the Soul's Vendetta waypoint and complete the heart there. Just like before, once the heart becomes a vendor, you can pick up your next Mist Entangled item. Back at Eli, we're gonna purchase all previous items, including an auxiliary condenser lens for 50 Mistonium, 5 globs of ectoplasm, 300 volatile magic, and 10 amalgamated gemstones. Once again, combine your items, hit the red button, select a skin, and now we can head back to the Yetendi Village waypoint, this time headed towards the volatile magic vendor right nearby. For just over 100 volatile magic, you should be able to pick up your next Mist Entangled item, and we'll head back to Eli. Once again, purchase all previous items, and the new item this time is going to be an automatic fire extinguisher, this time for 50 Mistonium, 5 globs of ectoplasm, 300 volatile magic, and those two swim speed infusions, the plus 10 ones I was talking about earlier. Combine your items, hit the red button, select your skin, and finally we're on to the chest piece. Just like with all the previous ones, we need one last Mist Entangled item, but unfortunately, we're not going to be able to get that just from a vendor. Well, honestly, it's really not that unfortunate because you get to fight the Shatterer boss that was added in Jahai Bluffs. Just like all other world bosses, this is on a timer, and I'll be leaving a link to the timer in the description. Make sure that the timer is up, and you should head over to Soul's Vendetta waypoint. Make sure the escort event starts, and then you'll just be escorting some dervs all the way to the Shatterer boss. Now, I should mention that there are several escort events or defense events that build into the Shatterer encounter, but for the sake of this guide being as long as it's already gotten, just head to Soul's Vendetta waypoint and follow that escort event all the way to the dragon. Be sure not to try this yourself or even with a small group. Rather, open your looking for group tool and wait for some people to gather for this event. The fight itself is pretty much what you would expect from a world boss, but there are some mechanics going on. Just be sure to listen to your commander and follow their lead so that you guys can all successfully complete this event, either for the loot or in your case for the mist entangled item. Head back to Eli for the last and final experiment. Again, like all the previous armors, we're going to be purchasing everything we purchased before, only you'll notice that the automatic fire extinguisher is now gone, and it's been replaced with the thermal emplacement. You could pick this up for 50 lumps of Mistonium, 5 ectoplasm, 300 volatile magic, and 1 heart of the destroyer. Combine all these items one last time and hit that red button to finally unlock all 6 pieces of the Requiem armor set. In my previous video where I talked about how to get the Elegy armor, I also mentioned that you could get all 3 of the classes of armor, so light, medium, and heavy, and the Requiem armor is now officially unlocked for you to purchase the other 2 classes. Unlike last time though, we won't be crafting these, rather you'll need to grind up some more Mistonium, and that's about 375 lumps of Mistonium per set of armor. And then once you're ready, head back to the Attendee Village waypoint, head back to that volatile magic vendor, and here you can see that now that we've completed this collection, we can now purchase the other classes of armor for some Mistonium and some ectoplasm. As a final note on this guide, a lot of what I've just covered has to be done in sequential order. So for instance, if you were watching this and thinking, well, I'm just going to complete all of the hearts and get all the mist entangled items right away, you actually can't do that until you're on that current part of the collection. So until you get those previous skins, you won't be able to move forward. And that, guys, is everything you need to know about how to get the Requiem armor set. I think the biggest hang-up with this are those superior sigils of nullification. Why those were decided as an item that would be required for this collection, I don't know. But hey guys, I hope you get at those sigils on the trade post before the price gets too high. I know I got them when they were around 13 gold a piece, and that was kind of painful. But anyway guys, I hope you found this helpful. I hope this helps you get that new armor skin. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.